Hi everyone. Today at the Potter's House Art Center, we're going to make something out of this little small piece of clay. I don't even remember what it weighed, but a lot of times when I just have a little bit left from a bag of clay, I'll just throw something small. We could make it a candle holder, we could make it a shot glass, we could make it a tea bag holder, but I think what we're gonna go for is a tall, thin candle holder as opposed to one that you would melt your wax and put in. So the first thing we have to do, like always, is get it centered on the wheel. I do all the steps that I do the same regardless of if it's a half a pound of clay or if it's 10 pounds of clay. Well, 10 pounds of clay, I maybe go up and down a little bit more with my coning, but I still do all the same steps. You find a way to throw that works for you and stick with it and just keep throwing the same way all the time and you'll become a pretty good potter, or a very good potter. Probably better than me. I started very late in life, so not that good as I could be had I started back when I was 20 or so. Find my right speed here. Now I'm going to open this up. Get a nice little compression going there in the bottom. I don't want this to be real wide. I'm going to start raising it. You want to color it in. This is called coloring it in when you're bringing it in with all of your two thumbs and two fingers here. We're coloring it in. And when you go from a wider pot to a smaller pot, it's very common to get it uneven at the top, but that's okay. I can fix that at a later time. Get that excess water out of there. Oh, I think I said that I was going to make a candle holder, but I'm making a vase, a very small vase. I just forgot. I just said the wrong thing. Sorry about that. I hope you didn't get your heart set on seeing a candle holder. I'm just making this nice little vase with just a little bit of extra clay that I had. I'm going to use my rib and take off some of this excess slip on the outside edge. If you don't do that, it could potentially crack down the side because it would dry quicker from the inside than from the outside, and you don't want that to happen. Does it happen very often? No, but it potentially could. But also, I just want my things to dry out nice and evenly. Less problems in the kiln when that happens. Now I'm just going to cut the top off from that a little bit because stretching it, coloring it in like I did at the top from wide to thick will give you a very uneven top sometimes. So we'll just take that little bit off. clean up that edge. Oh, I like how that looks. Just gonna press out a little bit and give it a little bit of a belly. I'm pressing out with my finger from the bottom, slowly coming up to the top. Whenever you're working with clay, you will learn that clay doesn't like any drastic motions. Everything needs to be slow, steady. Okay, I like that. It's gonna be a nice little piece for just using up a little bit, probably about half a pound of clay at the most. It might even be a little bit less than that. And there's our nice little vase. It'll be beautiful when finished. I might do some Sgraffito on this too. And again, I thank you for joining me at the Potter's House Art Center in Fairview.